Please stand for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today is Wednesday, May 20th, 2015. I'm Melissa Patari.
And I'm Josh Hill, and time for KTV Live Innovations.
So Josh, we're in the middle of the week, today's Wednesday, we're almost done.
Yeah, we're ending the year off pretty nice. In my opinion, it's going kind of fast.
Yeah, we got a long weekend and great show, so let's just get into it.
Let's get into it.
Today's KTV holiday is Pick Strawberries Day. According to HolidayInsights.com, Pick Strawberries Day is a day to go to a field and pick some strawberries. According to Wikipedia.com, strawberries can be used for a variety of things such as fruit juice, pies, ice creams, milkshakes, and chocolates. Also, eating strawberries puts you at a lower risk for a heart attack when you are older. Strawberries are a great source of vitamin C, so be sure to pick some today and eat them.
Attention band and choir students, reminder that your teacher's signature forms for Great Adventure are due by the end of the day today.
Today's KTV birthday is Tony Stewart. According to FamousBirthdays.com, Tony Stewart is a NASCAR racer who has won the Sprint Cup Series in 2002, 2005, and 2011. Also, he was named the Rookie of the Year in 1996 in the Indianapolis 500. Tony Stewart will be turning 43 years old today.
Exponents are first taught in 6th grade, then go more advanced into them in 7th and 8th. The base is the bigger number, and exponents are the smaller numbers to the top right of the base numbers. To find the answer, you have to multiply the base times itself with the number of the exponent. An example is a base of 3 and different exponents to see how the values change. Exponents are necessary in pre-algebra and algebra 1.
Warrior?
Oh, all right, Alyssa. Hi, Alyssa. You're trying to steal my sports.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
I have to tell you the sports. So, last night, the Warriors played the Houston Rockets. And if you didn't already know, after reading it, the Warriors did win 110 to 106.
Wow, that's pretty close.
Yeah, it was a pretty close game.
High-scoring game.
Yeah, Steph Curry had 34 points, and James Harden was one assist away from triple-double.
That's great for him.
Yeah. And then in the NHL, the Blackhawks beat the Ducks 3-2 in triple overtime.
Wow, that must have been a really close game, even closer than the last.
Yeah, it went on for a while.
Yeah.
Thanks, Alyssa.
See you later.
Recently, in Ms. Mayu's 8th grade honors classes began reading and analyzing poetry from a very famous poet. What is the name of this poet? Is it A, William Shakespeare, maybe B, Edgar Allan Poe, or could it be C, Robert Frost? This poet liked to write sonnets, a type of poem that contains 14 lines, and the answer is A, William Shakespeare. According to eQuotes.com, Shakespeare wrote 154 sonnets in total. Shakespeare's sonnets were published in 1909 and died 7 years later in 1619.
Come support the Johnson softball team as they participate in a home run derby to fundraise for the Collins family. Home Runs for Tyler will take place Wednesday the 20th at 7 p.m. at Brewer. Tickets can be bought in advance during lunches this week. So, Josh, I think we got a little break in the show.
Yeah, I can't really wait to see that.
I wonder what it's going to be about. Super duper interesting, though.
Yeah, so let's get it over there.
What's up, guys? We got a form for the New Jersey Heat All-Star Cheerleading Squad.
Yep, and the team registration will be held at our temporary facility located at Rebounders, 76 Carter Drive in Edison. The last registration date is Wednesday, May 20th, from 6:30 to 8 p.m.
It's a $20 sign-up fee. I just want to let everyone know that Rebound is not the permanent location. We're building a new one, and it's also in Edison next to Retro Fitness. So back to you guys in the studio.
So that sounds really nice.
Yeah, make sure you get your forms in tomorrow, because Wednesday the 20th is tomorrow.
No, today's Wednesday the 20th.
Oh.
But that's great.
Oh, yeah.
So
today is
back
Wednesday.
Into the news.
Okay.
SpacePlace.com states that a meteor shower is a number of meteors in the sky during a particular time in the year.
The Leeward meteor shower just recently took place, and people located in the Midwest and Mid-Atlantic were able to witness the dazzling flame. This week-long meteor phenomenon reached its peak on Thursday morning on April 23rd.
Now, the faster it's going, the more oxygen it passes through, so it really heats
up. These specific meteors are called Leewards and are caused by the comet Badger. A study of the 2014 Leeward shower showed that an average of 15 to 20 meteors will hit the Earth per hour. However, debris from this comet falls to the Earth every year. A scientist at NASA says the average meteor is very small because while traveling through the Earth's atmosphere, the spacecraft is worn down by the force of air and other atmospheric gases.
You're right, half pint. Not a big meteorite because it probably got burned up going through the atmosphere.
The next meteor shower is the Perseids, which is expected to occur July 13th to August 26th, reporting for KTV on Earth.
You can check out earthsky.org to find a list of meteor showers in the coming year.
Are you interested in becoming a peer leader? See Mr. Falco in room 16 for a PALS application for the upcoming school year.
Okay, Alyssa, you might have seen me run in here before because I was just so excited about this really warm weather that's
coming. Yeah, it's
coming
really
up.
Warm, so let's hear about it.
So today it's going to be partly sunny with a high of 70.
Wow.
And then the same is going to go for tomorrow, high of 70, also partly sunny.
It's a pretty good temperature.
Yeah, some might say also partly cloudy. And then on Friday there's going to be sunny with a high of 77.
Wow, it's getting even warmer.
Yeah, I really like the number 77. I feel like that's the perfect temperature.
Yeah.
But then continuing on Saturday, for those of you that don't like such high temperatures, it's going to be sunny with a high of 73.
Oh, it's still pretty warm, but not hot, hot.
Yeah, it's getting ready for Memorial Day, so hopefully we're gonna have some good weather then,
yep,
too.
Yep, see you later.
Bye.
Jimmy Kimmel bid his tremendous influence of his life, David Letterman, a heartwarming farewell. Letterman is retiring from hosting his long-running talk show, and Kimmel was very emotional when congratulating him.
On this day, 373 years ago, Montreal, Canada was founded. Montreal is the largest city in the province of Quebec with a population of approximately 4.1 million. Let's just get back to the teleprompter, please. According to Canadian Encyclopedia.com, the most spoken language in Quebec is French at 57%. It is the second largest city in the world that's main language is French. The most played sport in Montreal is ice hockey with a professional hockey team known as the Montreal Canadiens. Montreal was first incorporated as a city in 1832.
So Alyssa, you're back.
Yeah, and I think we got the last break in the show.
All right, so let's go see what they have to say to us.
All right, thanks, guys. In tomorrow's show, we have a video about the NHL playoffs.
And we also have a quiz about this new type of bullet. It's really cool, so.
Sounds like a great show.
Great show tomorrow.
Pass back to you guys in the studio.
I think that also sounds like a good show. Can't
wait
to see what that's about.
For even more KTV news, subscribe to us on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook. For Josh Hill and the rest of the KTV news team, I'm Melissa Patari. Have an amazing day.